What's up, YouTube? It's your boy ASMR TV, and I'm back with another video. I know it's been a grip since your boy has uploaded. It's something called college. That place is evil. That's not the point. As y'all came to the video, I came to see how to get dreads like Juice WRLD. And actually, this is actually finna be a new series for me. I'm actually gonna start comparing. I'm starting looking into other people's dread journey since your boy is fishy, a real life dreadhead, like feel like a little roster. But yeah, man, check out what I've been doing, bro. Freeform still, send my freeform because my tips are maintained. As you can tell, they are well maintained. But from the root, just let my hair grow up, let it nap up. But actually, I don't let it nap up. I actually comb out my roots because I noticed, I don't know. I just like combing out my roots. Is that weird? Is that, I don't know. But y'all came to see how to. How to get dreads like Juice WRLD. Juice WRLD is probably like my biggest role model, like just in life, period. Yes, he died at a very young age, but dude was lit. Bro was a goat. I don't care nobody say. I even got a book bag. You know, I'll be right. Like, I am a big Juice WRLD fan. Like, seriously. But yeah, I'm home for the weekend. I had a, cause it's homecoming night, and all my crew gonna be out there, and everybody wanted me to pop out, so I decided to come home. And also spend time with my family, cause I have not been home in like 2 weeks. For all my little jits that's considering going to college, don't do it. Work or start your own businesses. Boy, college is stressful. I'm starting doing vlogs. I should start doing vlogs on my journey about college because people really want like the inside look on how college is. It's not what people is. The party's lit, don't get me wrong. I haven't really been to no big events because, you know, we got COVID. Niggas sick, niggas dying. I'm not trying to be sick or die because I like my life. But how to get dressed like Juice WRLD. So let's look into how Juice WRLD dreads actually were. Juice WRLD, you can tell, like me and Juice WRLD dreads. That's who I really, that's why this Jerry Jr. right here, I really tried to get a close resemblance to Juice WRLD dreads. Like I even got the front Congo, like him in the front. I start free forming. We both had very, well his locks ain't, well his locks wasn't skinny no more. Like a little bit before his passing because he let him Congo off because he started free forming. But we almost have the same type, and people say me and brother are very similar. I don't see it at all. I don't, but it is what it is. But how to get dressed like Juice WRLD? I can say either get your hair twisted by hand or just go with a sponge. Me personally, the route I choose was sponge because I'm not finna sit in no chair and pay money for something I can do for myself. All these dreads, don't mind the cut because I ain't got no cut. All of this was me. Every single dread in this head, I did this. It took me a long time, but I conquered something with my dreads. Like, for real. I mean, like, me and dude dreads are almost similar. But your rule number one, either get it twisted up to a point. Your tips are looking something like mine's right here. Best way to get it, best way to put it, and let your hair lock up. Then once your hair locks up, phase two, freeform. Do not maintain your hair. Do not wear no cap to sleep. Don't freaking get no retwists. Don't separate your congos. That's a problem I used to have. I used to separate a lot of my congos. But man, I have a bunch of them. I got this one right here. This is probably my thickest dread in my head. I actually think this is the thickest. It's between this one or this one. I think these are two thicker ones in my head. I just let them congo up and let them grow out. You can tell, cause this is part where there's two separate dreads. Then from here on out, they start growing as one. Congos are legendary. If you have congos in your head, I respect you. I don't care. Another tip I could say you can do, if you really want the full look, to get your tips bleached. Me personally, I have jet black hair, but due to me recently working out during like the late summer, my hair got sun bleached, so now my hair is like this cool looking. I mean, you can't really see it because you kind of see it now, like that cool brownish color. You can kind of see it right here. You see how some of my tips are a little lighter than others. That's just due to the sun just cooking my hair, basically. But yeah, it's not hard. Like, especially me personally, I like freeform locks more because your dreads don't look like everybody else's. Everybody see my dreads, like, man, this one's fire, because they don't look like everybody else with the twists, designs, is that a third. If I wanted to go that route, I could. But that's not the route I'm going for. I want to see how my hair look 5 years from now. Freeform. No maintaining. None of that. Just straight chilling. For me personally, what I can say to get your hair to grow faster, just in case you want to know, is actually just let it grow. Don't put no products in your head. Don't put products in your head. I don't mean like little growth and sprays. This and the third. Too many stuff ain't got half of that stuff in that. There's a lot of stuff in them, in the products, that aren't actually good for your hair. Like a product that I usually use, say moisture, that stuff. They have some stuff in your hair that actually dries out your hair, and it slows down the progress in your hair growing. So even though your hair may have that shiny look or that good feeling, your hair is actually dying, and it's no progress in your hair growth. But I don't know, everybody's hair works differently. So that's why I can't really sit here and say, find products that works for you and for your hairstyle. Me personally, I don't put nothing in my hair no more. Only products that I do use is Jamaica Lime and Gel. If it's not Jamaica Lime and Gel, I'm not putting it in my head. I still use a locking gel. You know, my dreads are locked. I still use it. But one thing about what made Juice WRLD dreads was so unique, because he had one congo that stuck up about right about here. Now, how did he achieve this congo? Nobody knows. It was actually something like this, very similar. Is it on this one? Nah, you can't really see it because on his right side. But he had all these dreads back here congoed up in that one dread, because he didn't have no dreads on his face. You can see his fade on that side. And that really made his dreads very unique, because you wouldn't see nobody rock nothing like that. Me personally, I actually thought about getting a wig right here, just like Juice. But I don't know yet. Y'all tell me in the comments on how this look will look on me, or how should I let it wick up. Because yes, I do want to do something new with my hair, because I have so many dreads. Like, so many dreads. Like, it's 1, 2, 3. But it's just look at these dreads in this one little ponytail. And I am to count all the unknowns I have in my head. I have a good set of number of dreads in my head. That's why I really like my hair, and that's what really makes people, especially on the dreadheads, they be like, wow, bro, have mad dreads in his head, and they're not falling off. I didn't have one dread to fall off my head yet. Even my skin, my skinniest one up here. Where he at? I'm gonna tell y'all a little story once I find him. when your dreads get long, it's actually hard to find certain dreads. I know he up here. Here we go. This one. This little buddy right here. I'm gonna tell y'all a story about him. This was a dread that didn't want to, well, this was a piece of hair that didn't want to cooperate. No matter how much I spin brushed it, no matter how much I twist with my hand, burr would not lock up. He wouldn't. He was so stubborn, like he didn't care. So eventually, over time, I guess he saw the under hairs locking up, and that one piece of hair didn't want to lock up with no dread. I tried to twist him around under dreads. Can we press it? I don't like interlocking. I actually interlocked some of my dreads. I got three head to go. I got this one three head to go. This dread is right here. It's interlocked. Because it was three very skinny dreads put together. He looked like a little man. Oh, yeah. Need to focus on it. But yeah, I got this three head to go. For Polo G and them boys song. And I don't like interlocking because if you interlock the wrong way, you have a mad space gap between your locks at the root, and it just look weird. And when you get retwists, if you decide to get retwists, it won't twist up correctly. It will unravel at any given moment. So what you have to do, you either can go in yourself and try to fix it. That's what I had to do personally. And to be honest, I didn't fix this one because it's still at the root. I got two dreads that's combined. But I still have one dread that's off. No, I'm just gonna bring it a little closer. See, I can actually see it. Okay, here got a dread. You see how, okay, you see the difference? I got this dread over here chilling, and I got these two dreads combined. I gotta get them all connected so they can be one dread, but I mean, I'm free forming. All my new growth is showing it away. So it really don't matter to me at this point. I'm just letting my hair grow. But yeah, getting dreads like Juice WRLD, it's not hard. After you do all the methods I told you, get a retwist, let it lock up, then let it free form to get your little hair tied.